Okay, let's try this again. Excuse the darkness. The sun's going down, but it's still pretty out here, so I like sitting out here. But anyways, this is my third and a half attempt to make this video. For some reason, everything's been happening and trying to stop me. And first it was a sneezing attack, and then twice the videos, my camera stopped, and I had it plugged in, so it wasn't like it was having problems, and it just died. So I'm gonna try it again and see how it goes. After this attempt, if it doesn't happen, then I guess it's not meant for me to talk about, but I'm not gonna be swayed either way, and I'm not gonna be fearful. But anyways, coming from my background, if you've watched any of my other tapes, you know that I've come from a satanic ritual abuse background, and because of those things, I now can see people that use satanic rituals or mind control, or you know, even those spirits or entities, because they're not human beings, not in my book, that these things use, these demons. And since that experience, I really can see some stuff, and now I'm starting to see everything, you know, all people that you wouldn't even think that would be involved in that satanic stuff is involved in it, and even in the flat earth community. But before I get to flat earth, I had started going through my counseling and everything like that, and I learned about flat earth during that time period, kind of like as my second awakening, because I was starting to work on myself and go to counseling and working out the problems that I had, you know, and start addressing those things. And that's when I first come to the realization, I mean, heard about flat earth, and I was pretty accepting of it pretty much right away. And so anybody that comes here, and this isn't a flat earth channel as far per se, it's about me discussing flat earth, it just happens to be something that I believe in, and nothing's going to change my mind about it. So if any trolls decide they want to come and say stupid stuff, they will be blocked and go on, because no matter what they say, I know we're on a flat stationary plane. And that's the end of that. And the only other thing about regarding that is I don't know whether it's an infinite plane or there's a dome over us. Ain't never been there, ain't never saw it, so I don't know. But I know one thing, I don't take the word of anyone else. I prefer to use my own eyes, not someone else's. So at any way possible, if I can, you know, get any new information and verify it for myself, then I'm good with it. But I don't follow anyone. I don't feel like anyone's my leader. I'm my leader. And, but it goes to the story of, you know, what's going on in the flat earth community right now, and, you know, all this transhumanism, transgender, is just another way for these satanic people to take control and get a stronghold on people. I'm not religious, I am spiritual, so please nobody come with me to the real the real religious thing, because I'm not going to accept that. I'm not saying that I don't believe in God, because I do. I do believe that there is a creator. And my creator, the one who created me, was a loving creator. Those beings that people are seeing now and starting to observe now, they're not created by the loving creator. They're created by Satan, and his minions are demons. And I wouldn't use any satanic beings, any satanic sayings, anything satanic. Whether you want to call it the Illuminati, whatever you want to call it, you know what satanic is. Anything other than God, you know, that's made by or created by God. The rulers of this world, as they say. But, when I first found out about it, of course I found out that Pat Steer, she lived in Houston. She lives in Houston. I live in Galveston, which is about 50 miles from there. So, of course, I was very excited to meet a fellow flat earther, someone who thought the way I did, or at least I thought they thought the way I did, and where we could have a connection. I don't have a lot of strong female connections, and this situation didn't help it at all. So it's not that I can't be close to females, it's this that I'm very, very weary and guarded, and it takes a lot for me to get close to a female, really, really close to a female. But I was trying to give it a chance, since I've, you know, was working on me and working on everything that was going on and seeing all the truth that was happening and everything like that. And so she had that little dinner thing, and I went to it, and it was nice. It was just, there was still something that just, I felt like I felt out of place, because for one, it was in the most expensive place probably in Houston, the area wise. You know, they had valet parking for, I've never had my car valet parked, and I probably won't, okay? And I can park my shit and walk myself, you know? That's just not me. But anyways, so, you know, she has it at this real expensive Italian restaurant, and the average probably plate price there for the cheap stuff is like $30. So, you know, sorry. I cook my own food, and I would never, ever pay that much for some food. I wouldn't do it. But anyways, so she has this big, huge dinner, and at this real swanky, matter of fact, I felt kind of like, I'm not saying like underdressed, because I really wasn't, because there was people that were way more underdressed than I was. It's just like, I don't know, I just couldn't connect. I didn't feel like I could really connect with anyone there. But I don't know, I mean, the food was good. I have to admit the food was good, but I'm a vegetable lover anyway, so. But had that, and didn't really have any conversation with her. She was floating around, chit-chatting, talking to people, and it just really no connection, you know. I didn't connect with anybody there, you know. And it was just like, okay, you know, I mean, it was kind of a letdown, because it was all new, and it just, the people that were there, you know, just a lot of it just wasn't, I didn't, wasn't feeling any kind of connection with anyone there. And Jason was the only one that I somewhat kept in, I didn't even really keep in contact with him. It's just that later on down the line when I came out, he was there too, and so I talked to him. So, because I had always kept him as far as a contact in my social media stuff, and also Patricia. But anyway, so she does this meeting Antonio, and all of a sudden decides to uproot in her life and move to England, you know, and I was happy, you know, I mean, because I'm happy for anybody that finds somebody that they are like-minded with, or at least that's what I was led to believe. And so, you know, I hear that she's going there and she's engaged and she's in love and oh la 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 la, you know, and everything like that. And so I'm really not paying much of attention because things started changing and she started acting different, and of course no communication after that because she was in England and, you know, lost all the communication. And so, yeah, it was just kind of real weird. And so, like, then a couple months go by and she leaves a message on my Facebook, because I had this Flat Earth Census group, and she's like, I'm back in Houston, I'll be back in Houston again. And I'm like, what the fuck, wait a minute, I thought you was getting married, what the hell, you know, wait a minute, didn't you just move everything there to England, including your cats and everything like that, and you're already come back? Oh yeah, it's a long story, I'm going to have to tell you about it, but I want to tell you about it, you know, when I get back, we'll set up a time for us to meet. Now, before then, we never really we just had that thing, and a couple of times before that, I was trying to call her and meet with her, because I would come to Houston and stuff like that, and she would never answer my calls. And she might text me back 2 or 3 days later, oh, I was busy, you know, whatever like that, so I'm like, yeah, whatever. And so, so she's like, well, when I get back, we'll meet up and I'll tell you everything that's going on. Okay, well, here's the deal. I'm not a drama queen. Never have I been a drama queen. I'm just not into that shit. I have enough drama in my life in general that I've been through than to imagine up some bullshit. But she's like, yeah, I'll be back in Houston, blah, 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 date. You know, you want to come meet me and we'll have coffee. And I was like, yeah, cool, that's cool. You can tell me what's going on. I was trying to be a good person, you know, and, you know, I'm not going to say friend because I didn't know her well enough to call her a friend. It's just I was trying to be a good person and be a good listener, you know, and stuff like that. Because I thought, honestly, I thought she was going to be a really, really upset, really, you know, but no, it wasn't any of that. She, like, it was no skin off her back that she lost close to upwards of $20,000 or better for nothing. And I mean, I'm sorry, I'm a big baby, you know, I would have been boo-hooing and crying, and not only that, I would have been fucking upset. I mean, in 2 months period of time to go through that much of a roller coaster and act like it wasn't shit? So I was just like, a lot of that didn't make sense, you know, when she was telling me about this, but I kind of jumped forward, but yeah, she called me and wanted me to meet up with her in Houston, And I live, like I said, 50 miles away from there. That's 100 miles round trip. Knew she was the one that set up the time, the place, you know, everything like that. She was going to take care of it all. And so I get to the place. I'm supposed to be there at noon. We're supposed to be there at noon, meet up at noon. And I get there maybe 11:55, okay? So I'm knowing how downtown Houston is, especially around lunchtime. So I'm like, yeah, I might need to get, you know, find a seat. I don't know what this place is like, and I've never been here before, so I'm going to try to find a seat. Now, mind you, the whole time she was texting me talking about, I'm just down the street. I'll be there in a few minutes. I'll be there in a few minutes. Well, the few minutes went to 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes. And people were trying to get, you know, sit down and have their lunch and stuff like that. And here I am holding a table, nothing. So I just got up and, you know, let people have their table. See, any other time I would have just got up and left that bitch, because that was rude. You know, I hate, but that's like a pet peeve of mine. If you make plans with me, especially if you know I'm coming a long ways away, and be there on time. Time is a stickler to me. And when you don't care about a person's time, that means you're a selfish bitch. And that's what she was. She was a selfish bitch. She knew I was coming from almost an hour away and everything like that. And she didn't give a fuck. All she thought about was herself. But anyway, so I waited. And she kept on texting me. And here's the thing that got me down later on, once I realized what was going on. Because my therapist talked to me about it, because she saw the tape that she made with me. And she was the one that brought it to my attention about her bringing up satanic ritual stuff for mind control stuff. She was the one that brought it to my attention. Until then, I hadn't saw it. I just was feeling weird about certain things. But anyway, so because she was taking so long, I walked across the street because there was a little secondhand store there. And I like, it's like a Goodwill, but for rich bitches. Man, you should have saw the prices on some of this stuff, man. Man, they need to be shot. But, you know, I guess that would have